Iran, and we can make a tour all over the globe. And of course, I'm involved in some advising about your people, and I cannot, and I'm not here for giving advice, but the problem that you have with the Goritz North, the problem you face here, and the problem that you face in here, it's a much more difficult, I know, because it's strategic important, and the Abkhaz were not even majority there, it was just by power. And you face the same problem that you cannot fight with big power. I remember Ben-Gurion, now he was so smart, the founder of Israel. Never ever we will reach to a confrontation with a big power. And we had twice collusion with Russia. And we did it only when America was behind us. Otherwise, you cannot fight against big power. You have all the time to make all the problems. And we share this exactly the same stories that you have here. I don't need to tell you about your area. Of course, I can tell you that we share the same problem. We are in an island between the Arab world, and you are in an island, such a beautiful island in a world of the Muslims, even from the Russian part. And we have to, and please remember, it's our ambassador from the last Shiite in Iraq to Jordan and Israel, it's about 4 or 5 hour drive. And from Lebanon, it's some minutes. And the distance from the last Shiite here to Caucasus, to Tbilisi, it's about 30 minutes drive. We face the same problems and we have to take it in our national securities. But they have their own problems. And this is a wonderful map of Iran. And if I don't know, if just to remind you, and then I will leave you for questions, if you ask me, 360 degrees around, it's American huge army. Just along the Persian Gulf today, it's called the Fifth Fleet, with about 3 air carriers, with 45 ships. All of them ready to crush Iran, just they need the command. If you don't believe me, then the Pakistani, the Afghani, the Turkmens, Azerbaijan, all over American bases. And in Ahmadinejad had its problems because all over, around, maybe the CIA pushed for more and more aggressions and terrorism. And it's a very unpleasant and complicated world. Okay, I will not talk about, maybe I will stop here and from your question we will see where I can head more. If you leave this room just with the understanding that you have a problem with demography, this, you ask me, must be now first priority.
We know that.
What are you doing? Coffee, ski, new dogs? You have to do something. You have to tell these girls that they will have twice salaries from the present time. And if you are coming to the university or to the foreign minister, here in the corner, we need to see kindergartens, the best kindergartens in the world, so to encourage them to have children and academic world as well, or life. Yeah? But crying, it's not enough. And I have to tell you my own experience. I serve as a professor. All the Israeli prime ministers since Rabin up to the present guy. It took me 18 years to teach Sharon what it means demography. What I just showed you in 40 minutes took me 18 years. Finally, he said, now I understand. This is the withdrawal from Gaza. So you have to preach and to push it because the time is running and you will reach a moment that you cannot change anymore. This is the tragedy. When Putin spoke in the TV to the Russian girls, it was too late because there are no more girls to produce new children in Russia. Can you understand me? So you have to be in a hurry. Immediately after this lecture, knock on the door of the Prime Minister, tell him this is the first priority. So thank you for listening, and it's open for questions. Please.
so afraid after your speech and my question. Please, your concrete recommendations. Please, I'm very afraid.
You know what happened? The American army chose the wonderful genius of the American army. They called them the Capstones, 19 generals, 4-star generals, and they prepared them to be generals. And they came twice to Israel and they met with me. One girl, everyone was whispering to me, you see this beautiful woman. She completed Stanford, and she's the only human being that walked in the space more than anyone else. Can you imagine what kind of brilliant people? And she said, you are not leaving this room before you will said at least something optimistic. So I said, first of all, do you know what is the difference between optimistic and pessimistic? I am very optimistic, but with experience. So the pessimistic people, they are very optimistic, but with experience. On the long run, I am very pessimistic. On the present time, just to come and to see Tbilisi after 7 years, I smiled the last almost 3 days to see how wonderful it is and what city I left in 2003. So we have reason to visit Paris, wonderful. But my job is to warn behind 20 years from now. And this is what I have to say. So, sorry. And if I will let you go outside, this is politicians, they will do it. Because they can cheat so easily. No, I'm a professor, and what I'm doing in the last 40 years in the Israeli army, they're not coming to listen at the end. I'm not from Hollywood, sorry.
My questions, I think that your main aim to say, come on guys, you have a real problem. No coffee, no restaurant.
No, in addition to. Of course, no, coffee is wonderful.
I would like to draw an analogy between Georgia and Israel, because before the Second World War, many Jewish came Israel after independence, and now in the last year and after Russian-Georgia war, many Georgians immigrated in Belarus that crossed border and to go in Europe in Poland, and now step by step Poland trying to deport Georgians. But it seems that for Georgians now the main problem to get rich, to have a name, but not families, not values. And I would like your recommendation in this case, why Jewish coming in Israel after independence and Georgians have other existential dramatic problems with conflict between soul problems and body problems, because Georgians now prefer body. I think you will understand my question is too hard, but I can't change.
You see, every one of us is troubled between many interests. I am Israeli with Israeli interest. I am Jew with international Jewish interest. I am a human being that I care about ecology and part of the world. We are mixed feelings. The moment Israel was founded, it was, you know, it's one of the great miracles of history that a nation after 2,000 years came back and managed to recruit back all his people. 70%, 70 countries came back. And you know, today, about 50% of the Jewish people globally are in Israel. And of course, every person, a Georgian Jew, has the same problem, where to stay. The same we had with the people from Moscow, from Vladivostok, and from London. And we can see even changes. It's difficult in Israel. They are returned back to Tbilisi in Moscow. About 100,000 Jews out of 1.1 million who came to infrastructure.